Possibly, yeah.
How that goes, but you know, it definitely needs to be a solid athlete.
So Perry Kale, here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment of truth, the one that we've all been waiting for. Our main event of the evening, proudly sponsored by our main event sponsor, Hellas Sprinting. And on the outside of the team, ladies and gentlemen, Australia versus Brazil. Introducing first, ladies and gentlemen, from the blue corner, fighting out of Perth, Western Australia, he is a forward, four-time world champion. Ladies and gentlemen, a couple of spectacular Over 4 years ago, he defeated the King of Australia tonight, Joe Kamar, in his very ring. Fighting out of Perth, Western Australia, and a resident in Australia, ladies and gentlemen, please,
make sure I'm reading this right. 59 fights, 51 wins, 23 by way of KO.
And he's only 25 years old. He was fighting coming out of the womb, literally.
For a kid who's 25 years old, that is an incredible fight record.
That is extraordinary. If you've never seen Toby Smith fight before, buckle up, man, because it's going to be something different. As I mentioned earlier, high quality training out of the pit in Western Australia. Australia's number one pound-for-pound fighter. Toby Smith, Power Play 39, main event.
And to afford a veteran like John Wayne Parr, like
he's not only fought, with all due respect to John Wayne Parr, he beat him, he destroyed him.
Toby's stats, let me give you some for Bruno. 40 fights, 31 wins, 20 via way of KO. There is no shortage of power coming into this ring tonight.
Every second person that Bruno Miranda fights needs the canvas.
That is a scary opponent to be coming up against.
And then you've got Toby Smith in the other corner, so this is blockbuster, man. This is one of the bigger fights we've ever had on Power Play.
Have an opportunity to use his renowned leg kicks that he's known for around the world against an opponent like Toby.
Oh, no doubt at all. But he'll find it. I think Toby's going to have some reach and a bit of height advantage here. So, and he does, 14 centimetres.
Significant.
That's significant. So, can Bruno get in close enough to land the shots that he needs to? Or will Toby keep him at distance? Remember, we're full-time rules here, so knee elbows in play.
And yeah, that height difference of Bruno might not have been such a big deal when he went to the MMA game, because the shorter fighters can usually take him down.
That's right.
Go to the mat, and my guess has been Brazilian that he'll have some level of jiu-jitsu underneath them. But in a tight match, that reach is going to have a massive difference.
Huge difference. Little pocket rocket Bruno Miranda. A lot of power in that figure. Legs, look at the legitimate girth of his size.
Three trunks, mate.
There's a bit of a hush over the male pavilion at the moment. Just it's pure anticipation for what we're about to see.
But you don't get a main event much better than this.
No, you don't. straight into it now. Not far away from our main event of Power Play 39. Toby Smith and Bruno Miranda.
The body size difference for two 76 kilos fighters, you wouldn't think it if you looked at them down the street.
No.
Toby a lot taller, a lot leaner. Bruno a lot stockier, a lot shorter. You can tell the muscle mass is a lot heavier on him.
Yeah, and they're going to use that to each of their own advantage in their own separate ways.
Thank you.
suspense.
It's like the hairs on the back of your neck just kick up when stuff like that happen.
Here we go. Main event, Power Play 39. Toby Smith, Bruno Miranda, 5x3, full tie rules. He who lands first, will loud, loudest it is one. Immediate head kick. Straight away though, you see the disadvantage of the reach. Bruno's out of range in his normal stance.
Yeah, that leg kick.
Good check. Good check. Away from kick. Again. Good body shot, right kick combination.
Bruno having to eat a couple to get in there, but he's going to have to do that.
Except he might eat a couple, Squally.
In round one. Good solid first round to gain. Bruno Miranda a bit more aggressive. Loved the left body shot into the right leg combo as well. That scored money in round one. Toby Smith, I think, didn't really use his range and his reach as much as he could have. If I was Toby, really not nowhere near his potential, but it'd be keeping Bruno on the back foot. Keep something in his face, keep the jab out there, keep the leg out there. At least that way, Bruno's put off balance, because right now, this is way too much to get inside.
Look, I couldn't agree more, but what I'd be able to say is, if this is a five-round fight, Toby, you know, in a five-round fight, you do have the ability to come in and feel out your opponent.
Of course.
And I think part of what Toby was doing there was saying, okay, what's this guy bringing to the table? How hard's he going to go? How quick? What's this guy's thinking? And they're like, get him in five rounds.
No, that's a great point, yeah.
Toby's corner not letting him take a seat.
That's old school Muay Thai. Bruno has opposite cover as well, so can sometimes just hamper the gas tank a little bit.
Both corners have been very comfortable though.
They did, yeah, both very comfortable in their own styles. Wes Smith screaming instructions to Toby in the corner. I reckon they're going to want a little bit more output from him.
Yeah, I think so. We go round two. See if he changes. Toby automatically on the front foot. Takes the centre this time.
Oh, body combo to head.
I love the body shots by Bruno Miranda. It's like a little pit bull. Look how much more aggressive Toby is.
Yeah, this is what we expected to see.
Feeling our process is well and truly over.
And like you said, and we've discussed, Josh, you can't feel that for too many rounds in a five round, you can lose it.
Exactly right. Toby's output is way higher already. 25 seconds into the first round.
See what they can offer in the clinch. Toby with the height advantage.
Yeah, Toby wanted the knees and elbows. So that's going to be his advantage in this fight, so he's a chance.
Another body shot on Bruno.
Yeah, he lands it on the ring girls then. Bruno's tough, man. Wow. Ultra aggressive. Good body kick by Toby.
If he lost his balance there or got hurt.
Toby took full advantage though.
Spinning back fist. Elbow by Bruno.
Good knee by Toby. And the elbow in the clinch. This is where he wants to live. Hurts Bruno with the knee. Oh, he's hurt him. He's hurt him bad. Oh! It's a knee to the body.
Wow.
That's over.
That was a
That is
knee.
Over. Gone!
That is all over.
Toby Smith, knees to the body in round two.
And Bruno is hurt.
Yeah, that's ribs, man. That's definitely ribs. Told you he's a weapon, man. Weapon by name, weapon by nature.
Those knees were vicious. He had him in that clinch and it was all over. Toby being a good sportsman, adrenaline's down, seeing how the opponent is.
Yeah, that was knees. That was about four or five knees into ribs. That's where Toby told me. I spoke to Toby a few weeks ago. That's where he was going to do it. He was going to do it in the clinch with the knees and elbows. That's exactly what he did.
Well, he always had the height advantage, and the clinch made the most sense. But Jesus, you can clinch, and then you can clinch and do what you just did. And look, I'm looking where the doctors are putting the ice, mate. I don't know if that's organ damage or rib damage, because that's a little more than the rib cage. That has done something serious to Bruno. Either way, he fought hard, he came out attacking Bruno, great respect to him.
They probably won the first round, man. They would have won the first round, so
he didn't look at an opponent like Toby and take it easy, you know?
You're exactly right, though, with what you said earlier. Toby clearly used the first 3 minutes of scope, and that was a different fighter in round two. He came out, and those knees, man, they're devastating. Hopefully, Bruno Miranda. Had the wind taken out of him to be up on his feet shortly.
Yeah, look, those knees came hard and fast and had multiple succession.
Yeah.
He could just knock the absolute wind out of him.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And, you know, he'll fight again, Bruno, no doubt, with a fight record like his. What is he? He's 28 years old.
Oh, plenty.
He's really got a long career ahead of him.
He'll probably transition back into the world of mixed martial arts, but he came up against an opponent tonight that just had too much.
Well, he didn't just come up against an opponent, he came up against the best tonight.
He did. Best that Australia has to offer.
Tell you what though,
checking on Bruno Miranda still.
I haven't seen Bruno's MMA career, but if he's just any good, he has that sort of strike.
Do yourself a favour, yeah? When you recover after this tomorrow, go on YouTube and YouTube some of Bruno Miranda's MMA fights. Devastating. MMAK, Powerplay series, Cage series.
We'll need to get Bruno back for an MMA fight if that's the part
he wants to go to. The guy's a machine. He's on his feet too, which is next.
We can get a champion, Bruno.
Oh, that's a broken rib.
We can get a champion, please.
Good to see him back on his feet. We go Perry Cale, center ring, for our final decision of Powerplay 39.
All right, thanks very much, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Jeff Eddie puts a stop to this contest. 1:40 in the second round. Your winner by TKO from Australia, Toby the Weapon Smith.
Bone Appearance has been Power Play 39. We'll see you on the 8th of December. Power Play Cage Series 1.
December 8th. Drive safely, everyone. Bye for now.